I'm about to jet off to the Peak District. I'm going on my own, going to retreat into solitude. I call it Peace Week or Peace Weekend because it is technically only 2 days and it is close to the weekend. I think this is an important part of just detaching yourself from the world, your routine, your life, just everything around you, and just going somewhere into nature. Not taking any laptop. I'm only going to use my phone for filming purposes only. I'm going to be on airplane mode, no Wi-Fi, no checking texts and messages. I put on my WhatsApp status that it's Peace Weekend, do not disturb. I feel like this is just going to be so fundamental just to reconnect back with myself, but just generally to just go away from the noise of the world, you know? So I'm filming this now just before I leave my hometown. It's going to take about 2.5 hours. I'll obviously take some nice photos as part of putting on the editing process. And obviously just to put some videos out there of what I've been going through. I'm going to do 2 hikes, one today called Lud's Church on Friday and then Mam Tour on Saturday. Then I'll return on Sunday. So guys, take care. Have a good weekend. And I hope I can bring you some wholesome content on the Peak District. Just started out Lud's Church, just arrived now. As you can see from the views, it's beautiful. It's raining, a little bit light rain. Expected that though. Look at that. In nature. It's the only time I'm gonna use my phone just to film, take some photos. I'm gonna give it a bit of a go. I don't even know where I'm going, no map, no nothing. So I could be lost, but I've gotta make it back before 5 to the car park, so we'll see how we get on. Yeah, look at that though. Peak District, baby. Lud's Church route, Friday the 29th. Here we go. Honestly, look at this. So what happens when you take a route you don't even know? Unplanned. Just a quick one, guys. Done Lud's Church. Realised that I didn't realise I did it so quicker than I thought, so I'm basically tackling like most of the Peak District now. I'm gonna try to anyway. Don't know if I'm doing the full pass properly, but I'm gonna do the Roaches path. I've just got here now. I'm gonna do the main path, head back all the way down to Danebridge, and then head back to Gradbach. Guys, just walking through the woods. Look at that, beautiful. Just birds singing now. Just did Roaches, which was great. I could have gone deeper into Roaches, I feel, but I'd be there forever. I'd be walking all day. So I'm going Danebridge now. I'm on the route there. And then kind of just go from there, see how I do with time, really. I haven't really planned what I'm doing, where I'm going. The road map is Lud's Church, and I've just taken like 2 extended routes with some maybe to come more, and obviously got tomorrow as well. Yeah, it just shows you how powerful this is. Sun's out, guys. Look at that. Sun's out, yeah, it's good. We keep tracking through the woods, keep going through the forest. But yeah, I'm glad the weather's out now. Makes the hike a lot more enjoyable. Right guys, just done with the Danebridge. I think maybe I'm gonna head back soon. Been walking for nearly 5-6 hours. Started at 9, it's nearly 2 p.m. now.
It's been amazing. Still feel alive. I've got a hike tomorrow as well, so I'm kind of playing it as I go along. Do I keep going, or do I just take it a little bit easy and head back to the Airbnb, walk around the area there to do a big walk tomorrow as well? We'll see. But it's been brilliant. Look at this, just being in nature here. So it's been amazing, honestly, just to detach. I'm on low battery as well, so I left my charger in the car. So if I have a dead battery now and if I'm lost in the woods, this is gonna be the last in video that I do if I die. But I won't, because I'm a tough man. So yeah, let's keep going.
Oh my God, it's just arrived back at Innisdale. I'm staying here in Airbnb. So I'm gonna rest for a bit, kip up. I might go for another walk this evening, Montage Trail. I'm gonna see how it goes though. Currently 4 o'clock now, so I'll just get my stuff sorted, get rested, get some food later on, and then hit the ground running.
What's up, guys? It's 6 in the morning. I woke up a lot earlier, because I always wake up at like 4:15 a.m. So I was up at like 4:30, 4:45. I was waiting for it to get light so I could just come out and just come for a walk, I guess. Wait till the light comes out. Look at this. Like, honestly, look at this. When I woke up in the morning, I kind of saw the lake or the river through the window. I just thought I had to come out. I had to be outside, and I'm going to do a bit, just like a little bit of a morning walk before I tackle the day of walking or hiking, if you call it. It's beautiful, so beautiful, so early in the morning, but man, it should feel so fresh out here as well. Like the smell, you just hear the birds chirping, it's so quiet. We've also got the church bells next door ringing, which was really nice as well. So it's been a fantastic sort of kind of experience, and I mean, just look how peaceful it is. Just so calm and so soothing. It was a really good day yesterday as well. Hopefully going to tackle the day with a lot of hiking, like I said. I'm doing the Montage Trail, so I'm going to do the Montage Trail in the morning and then make my way up to Mamtor in the kind of the afternoon, so that should take up most of the day, and then come back and relax, and then I guess get some food and prepare for tomorrow, really, to go home. But yeah, guys, you need to get into solitude, you need to get into nature. I think the most important thing to realize, and I think an important point which I realized from this, is do it on your own first. Really, honestly, if I could say, and I highly recommend you do something and do this on your own, don't really do this on your own. Go and do this in peace with yourself. Don't start with, I guess, like someone or someone you're close with, or, you know, it's good to do it with other people. Don't get me wrong. I feel you should always do this with other people, but I think experience it on your own first. Really experience it, then you can start to build the experiences with other people. And you know what the great thing is? You'll meet like-minded people as well on this journey.
Halfway up, walking back now, going through the tunnels again, which is going to be great. Yeah, got a little surprise at night time. Find out, going to hit Paddler's George later on. It's going to be good, it's going to be interesting. Alright guys, in Paddler's George, it's beautiful down here. Just started the route now. I don't know how long it's going to take. Obviously, I'm doing Mamtor tomorrow, which was meant to be planned today. But I did the Montage Trail earlier on, which took about 3 hours. Drove down here, which is about 20 minutes from Montage to Millersdale to Paddler's Gorge. Gonna do this trail now and then do Mamtor tomorrow. Gonna hit it up early in the morning. The only reason is because it's Easter Sunday and Saturday's busy and it's a nice day. So everyone's out. So Mamtor's gonna be packed today, so I've decided to change it up a little bit, go a quieter route. It's
seems pretty chill down here. Let's enjoy. Guys, just heading back down from Paddler's Gorge now. Been a good solid walk. I've done a few Stephen Uncut videos from it as well, which is gonna be nice. Yeah, just heading back down. Sun's still out, it's gorgeous today. It's been a really nice day for the hike. Yeah, gonna head back to the Airbnb now. Chill for a bit, I've got my meal at 7:30. I don't know how many calories I've burned today, probably a ton load, but treating myself with a little bit of nice food, ice cream, you know, that sort of stuff. So yeah, just gonna head back now.
Yo, what's up guys? I'm just literally back now, I'm just knackered, so I'm gonna kip for a little bit, go for an hour and a bit. I've got my meal at 7:30, and then later on I've got my surprise for you guys. You're gonna see.
Guys, I'm doing the Montal Trail, just what I did before in the light. I'm doing in the dark. It's currently 9:42 p.m. so it's pitch black. Tried filming with even my head torch on, can't really see anything. I managed just to stay at the Airbnb, get a bit of shadow light. What's gonna happen is I'm gonna do the trail, not the trail, I'm basically the tunnels that you saw earlier. I'm gonna go through one of them on my own. I've got literally just my rucksack, water bottle, myself, that's it, and light from my phone, but also the head torch, which the kind person at the Airbnb gave me. So I'm gonna head down there. I'm gonna do the trail. I'll try film what I can. Can't guarantee anything of how it's gonna be. So it's just gonna be a case of survival, really. Looking forward to it. I'm pretty nervous, I'm not gonna lie to you. I've never done this before, especially on my own. It's pretty nerve-wracking, but I'm looking forward to it. It's gonna be an adventure. Myth or legend myth in this village tells me that apparently there's a black cat lurking around. No one's ever seen it, no one's ever heard of it or done it, or seen it itself. But we will see. I'm gonna head through the tunnels. There's no light in there. So from earlier in the day, which you see there's a light shining through, there is no light. So yeah, that's why the head torch is there. I'm gonna go through it, see what I can do. I'll try and film what I can. Maybe poor quality, but we'll go from it. Yeah, gonna go through one of the tunnels. I'm heading towards Wydale, so see how far that goes. I've got a tricky part. First part, I've got to go up this steep cliff of the mountain or the hill, and it's a bit stony, so I've just got to be a bit careful in terms of how I portray and go about that. But I'm looking forward to it. Let's begin.
It's the trail, guys. Walking in. This is the mountain, guys. You can see, I'm just walking up here now. So this is the kind of steep mountain, I've just got to be careful of. Obviously I won't film all the way, a bit stony, but yeah, this is it.
Can't see me guys, but made it to the top.
Alright guys, just keeping you updated. I know the quality is poor, haven't got any lighting around me, but just continue walking the trail. It's dark, see you here. Just me and nature, that's it. Just me in the woods, me in the jungle. Yeah, just keeping you updated. Guys, as you can see here, that's the lime kiln. So this is where the person in the Airbnb, Elsie, said she stayed in that. It's crazy. Guys, I approach the tunnel. Through. This is it guys, that's the tunnel. I can't really show it, it's so clearly lit. To MP2 tunnel, just right there. That's my second tunnel to go through now. Let's get the second one done. Just get inside into the tunnel. Guys, to tunnels are complete. It was a shorter tunnel than I expected. You know, I could go down there. So what I've done now. I'm gonna head back. I've done what I've completed, I've done the two tunnels, I need to go right back through it all. Yeah. What an experience. That's something that just tackling fear.
What an experience, guys. You know, just tackling fear. I know you can't see me properly. But just being able to come out and do this in darkness on my own, back through the tunnels now to get back safely. What an experience, just tackling through the fears of everything. Who knows what I'll encounter on the way back, but that's it for today, guys.
All right, guys, just return to the Airbnb. I'm keeping quiet because everyone's asleep. I don't want to wake anyone up. Experience, honestly, just going out there in complete darkness, complete. Yes, there's that element of fear. You can't, you know, there's always like these things when you walk in darkness, things where you get fear, you get scared. It's like, what's holding you back? Why are you holding back for? Just to be able to challenge your mind up here, be able to overcome that fear. You know, even as something simple as that. Honestly, do you want me to be honest? It wasn't even that scary. It wasn't even bad at all. It's all the things that your mind creates before that experience. To then make like prejudgments based off that. So when I went and walked through that tunnel, I was just so present. I didn't care anymore. I didn't care what would happen, if something came out or attacked me or not. I just went in there with pure presence, with the faith that I'm going to make it through regardless whatever would happen. Because what happens when you go in these situations, your mind just creates all these negative thoughts, beliefs, these worries, these fears, anxieties. So I could have had that and I could have just turned back around and said, nah, I'm not doing this. But by me filming, by me speaking to you, by me actually wanting to do it by my own self, I pushed past that. You know, and me on my own as well, no one there to pat me up, no one there to cry on or a shoulder to be alongside me. It was just me and my own self conquering that fear, conquering that experience. And this is really important for any walk of life. You need to challenge yourself, challenge your mind especially, because it's funny, when you actually do the experience, you realize maybe it wasn't that bad at all. It was just my mind creating all these things, these worries and anxieties, these fears. And it's when we start to really push ourselves, when we start to put ourselves in those situations which are uncomfortable, it's when we truly start to learn. And now look, I've conquered it. I'm back here, I'm safe, now I can go to bed and sleep, I can be, you know, happy. So, tomorrow's going to be MAM tour. I'm going to tackle that early in the morning, so I'm aiming to leave here about 6 a.m. Might take about 4 hours, and then I think after that, it'll be a 2 hour drive for me, 2.5 hours, so I'll get back into my hometown around maybe like 1-2 p.m. Probably hit sauna before that and then enjoy the rest of Easter Sunday with my family. Guys, it's been a pleasure.
All right, guys, just started MAM tour. It's just 8 o'clock. Woke up a bit late. It was my alarm, my Casio was set wrong. So I think it was set to 4 p.m. instead of 4 a.m. So I woke up a bit later. I woke up at like 6-7. Clocks went forward because of Easter Sunday as well. So I hit that wrong. Looking forward to today, MAM tour. Just arrived, forgot all my food as well, left it in the Airbnb because I was rushing around to leave, I don't know why, but so I forgot to pack that, so I'm going to be doing a 4 hour hike fast effectively, which is going to be interesting. So I had a big meal yesterday, so it was all good, slept all good, just looking forward to this walk. Beautiful crisp morning, it's like 1 degrees now, so really nice day for it. Didn't even exist, but I actually made it to MAM tour. Here we are.